Well, good morning, everyone. It's Friday, May the 1st, May Day. It's a holiday in England. All right, so it's Stephen from the Patchwork Family YMCA. Today we're going to do two meditations. A quick one that's just going to concentrate more on relaxation, bringing you down, helping you to de-stress, especially in today's environment. When you're anxious, stressful situation, you don't have to do it in a meditation position. You can do it sitting in your car. Let's say you're getting a little anxious about going somewhere, maybe even going to the grocery store these days. Costco is the worst. And you're trying to figure out, okay, I need to just relax for a second before I go into that environment that's going to be stressful. Might even be going back to work. Eventually we'll all be back at work, and that in itself can also be stressful. So I bought a couple of, as you see, I'm on a mat. I have a meditation cushion. This is called a Zafu. This is mine. Z-A-F-U, I believe. How you spell it? Z-A-F-U. A lot of times you can either get these, they're filled with buckwheat or some sort of natural beans, so they can form to your body. And I've also got a yoga block, typical yoga block. You could use a pillow or something, or right now I'm sitting on my knees. This is more of a traditional martial art position that we use for meditation, but this can put a lot of stress on your knee joints if you're not used to sitting in this particular position. So I'm going to show you how to use the yoga block, and then I'm going to switch to my Zafu. Okay? All right. I also have water, excuse me. Drink lots and lots of water. You know, we're inside a lot these days, so we really need to drink plenty of water. All right. Okay. So again, this is more of a typical martial art position. School, before you get on the mat, when you train, we also do a lot of meditation in this position. But it can, you know, your legs go numb at some point for any length of time if you're not used to sitting in this position. So the yoga block first. Just place the block on the mat, and you're just going to raise yourself up. So we can sit either in a cross-leg position, or you can do the lotus or a half lotus. It's all the same. Okay, this is more comfortable for me than getting into the half lotus these days. When I was a kid, I could do the lotus, but too many injuries now preventing me from doing the lotus for any length of time. And whenever you meditate, you want to be able to relax. So the yoga block is perfect. Just lifts your tail up the ground, and we can sit in this nice comfortable position. Or in my case, I'm going to use my Zafu, which I have with me at all times. All right. So this is comfortable because it gives a little bit, whereas the yoga block a little more solid. Okay. Hand positions. You'll see a lot of people place their hands out on the knees. Again, as I explained last week, we're moving away from our center of gravity. The further we bring the hands out from the body, which has a tendency to bring our body weight forward, so eventually we start to stoop. Okay, so we spend more time supporting. This puts more brains stress on the lower back. My position is closer to the body. Men, left hand underneath, right hand on top. This is a yan position. Women, right hand underneath, left hand on the top. Yin position. Thumbs just pressing together. All right, so the first one we're going to do, again, you can do this in your car, you can do this sitting in a chair. It's called the 4-7-8 breath. It's not so much a meditation, but more of a relaxation, de-stressor. And it's something you can just turn on to bring in your anxiety or stress down. Or you can use it as a preliminary before you actually meditate. If you did the 4-7-8 breath for a few minutes, it helps bring you down. Then you can go into your meditation. Okay. The meditation that we're going to do is also considered a guided meditation as such, but it's called the inner smile. So it's connected more towards the category of mindfulness, okay? So we have mindfulness, and remember we also have mindlessness. There's always an opposite to everything. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is a very simple technique. Again, you're taking the tongue and resting it behind the top front teeth on the roof of the mouth. Just rest it there, don't press it, just rest it there. Shoulders are down and relaxed, back is straight, and if you can just tuck that pelvis under a little bit, get the lower spine, and the top of the head is always the meditation. Head is in the heavens, feet is in the earth, with the connecting between the yin and the yang, okay? So the 4-7 breath is, I'll talk it through. We breathe in for a count of four. Hold the breath for a count of seven. And then exhale for a count of eight. In the beginning, again, it might be a little bit difficult. That out breath does take some practice. Okay, then if you can hear some background noise, they're doing some construction outside the town. They're putting in new drainage. So you might hear some, I apologize if you can hear the dirt movers out there. So tip of the tongue on the roof of the mouth. So I'm gonna count, you don't have to count. Again, your second, we're looking for seconds. So in-breath is in-breath through the nose, out-breath through the mouth. As you exhale, you're going to make a shh sound. Like when you're telling someone to be quiet, you know, you say shh, or you have a child, or shh, trying to be quiet. So that's that shh sound, okay? Shh, sh, I guess an sh, shh sound. Shh. When you make the sh sound, shh, you can, if you're aware, you can become aware of your diaphragm, shh, and your abdomen, shh, to help contract and push the breath out. So we start by placing the tip of the tongue on the roof of the mouth. We breathe in through the nose for a count of four. One, two, three, four. Hold the breath for a count of seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And then we exhale through the mouth, making a shushing sound. Shh, for a count of eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. I realize that might be difficult for a lot of you, so the goal is to do seconds, like 1-1,000, 2-1,000, 3-1,000, but if you go 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4-5-6-7, and then 1-2-3-4-5-6-7-8 exhale. So I'm going to do it, we're going to breathe. Again, we only do this for a few minutes, it's very quick, works very well. It also works well if you're having trouble sleeping. So before you go to sleep at night, it's a great way of turning the mind off because it has to focus on the breath and helps calm you down. So again, tip of the tongue on the roof of the mouth and breathe in through the nose. One, two, three, 4, hold the breath, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale through the mouth, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, in through the nose, 1, 2, 3, 4, hold it for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale through the mouth, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. In through the nose, 1, 2, 3, 4, hold it for 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, hold it, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, hold it, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, couple more, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, hold it, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, once more, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, hold it, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, finish. So I realized again, doing it in this setting can also create stress or anxious. Some of you might be breathing faster, some of you might be breathing slower. So again, I apologize. You go at your own pace when you're breathing. Okay, so things to remember, tip of the tongue, roof of the mouth, in through the nose, hold it, exhale through the mouth, making the SH shh sound, shh. Feel tightness in the lungs, and you'll feel the diaphragm, shh, 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 okay? The whole idea is to keep the body upright, not sag. All right, shoulders back, chest is open, breathing down here in the belly. Deep diaphragmatic breath. Okay, so it's very simple. Technique. And again, when you're focusing on the count, your mind helps bring your mind down to relax, quietens the mind, gets rid of the monkeys in your head. Okay, so we're going to do a meditation. It's a mindful style meditation. It's called the Inner Smile. It's a very nice meditation to help you down, relax, calm, just become aware of your body. Again, we spend so much time outside of our body that we never really focus on what's happening on the inside. So meditation is a tool that we can help us to look inside of our heart, inside of our soul, and see what's going on. So I want you to get into your comfortable position, whether you're sitting on a meditation cushion, whether you're sitting on a yoga block, you might even sit on the floor, also on a chair. I have my chair over there, so I wanted to do it on a cushion. Chair, same thing. Make sure it's a high back chair. So something that's not, you're gonna sink into and relax. But you wanna keep the spine straight. Again, left hand in the lap, right hand underneath for males, right hand, left hand, and females, yin and yang. Top of the head, all the way up, lift, lift. Visualize the spine. For this meditation, you're gonna keep the tip of the tongue on the roof of the mouth the entire time. And breathing is in and out through the nose. OK? Okay, so we're not exhaling out of the mouth this time, unless, of course, it's allergy season, or maybe it's asthma, or you have some issues with breathing, then, of course, you have to breathe out through the mouth. But ideally, we want you to breathe in and out through the nose. Usually, with any type of meditation, the first thing you want to become aware of is your breathing. So I just want you to get comfortable. There should be no pain or discomfort in the body, as that will distract from the meditation itself. Just close your eyes, or if you don't want to close your eyes, we call them you can call them half-lidded, which means you're looking basically down about 45 degrees with your eyes, not your head. So you're not looking down with your head. Your head is straight, but your eyes, your gaze is down. So when your gaze is down, your eyelids kind of half lid. Okay, so they're relaxed, they're partially covered as opposed to closing your eyes. Okay, so again, whatever is comfortable for you. First thing I want you to do, like anyway, is to become aware of your breathing. How are you breathing? Are you breathing in the chest? Are you breathing in the belly? When you breathe, are your shoulders coming up? Do they rise? Does your chest expand when you inhale? Does your stomach expand when you inhale? Does your stomach contract when you inhale? What happens to your body when you breathe? Do you find yourself breathing in more on the left side or more on the right side? Are both nostrils working? So listen to your body, find out where it is at this moment, because this is the moment that is important, not the next moment, not the moment that's past. This is the only moment that is important. You might find as you breathe, you'll notice that your breathing relaxes, becomes deeper. If it does not, that is fine also. Start looking around at your body. What's happening to your shoulders? What's happening to your back as you relax, as you fall deeper into meditation? The one thing we want to stay away with is the body shifting forward. You have to be very aware of your center. The spine is up. Another thing with meditation, again more so with the mindfulness meditation, is that there are noises. Things happen around you. If you're familiar with the patch of Y, we have our blowers right above our head. And they could turn on at any time. I'm just waiting for them to turn on Friday while we're meditating. The idea is to hear it, but let it go. So we have the sound of construction workers outside. They're laying large pipes. So you might hear the pipes land, the earth movers working. But again, you want to hear it, but let it go. Don't hold on to it. Just focus on your breath. When your body is comfortable, I want you to become aware of how you're sitting. Whether you're sitting in a chair, a cushion, on the floor. What part of the body is making contact with that support? Is it balanced? Is it equal? Do you sit more on one side than the other? Does your weight shift forward? Does your weight shift back? Of course, we always have to become aware of our spine. It's very important that we protect the spine. Any type of exercise, focuses should be on what is happening to the structure of the body. Whether you're in meditation, or whether you're lifting, working with resistance, working cardio, or some form of stretching type exercise. Always be aware of conscious of what you're doing to your spine. We only have one spine. We can replace lots of joints, but as of yet, we haven't been able to replace the spine. So we always have to focus on what's happening in the spine. And it's divided into vertebrae. Visualize that lumbar section of the spine, the lower section of the spine. Sacrum, the pelvis, it's called the pelvic girdle. Five lumbar vertebrae, the largest of all the vertebrae in the body, they have to carry a lot of load. I want you to visualize them. No pain or discomfort when you meditate in the lumbar section of the spine. I want you to visualize that the vertebrae, each of those vertebrae, five of them, open up, separate. Feel as your body lifts up. In the vertebrae, you have the discs. These are the body's shock absorbers. They're there for a reason. Now you're going to bring your awareness up to the middle section of your spine. Vertebrae. As we travel up the body, each vertebrae gets a little bit smaller. They have less weight to support. In the thoracic, they're a little more flexible. They enable us to lean side to side, enable to turn. We bend through that section. Thoracic side. Feel them lift up. those discs expand. Feel the ribs of the body open up. Next, bring your awareness to the neck, the cervical spine. We have 7 cervical vertebrae in the spine, in the neck. These are hyperflexible. Enable us to turn our head from left to right. Allow us to flex the neck, bring the chin down to the chest, extend the neck, bring the chin up to the ceiling. It's a hyperflexible joint. So we have to be careful of our cervical neck. Again, visualize each one of those vertebrae as they just extend up towards the heavens. Visualize the discs. What I want you to do is visualize the whole spine, lengthen up all the way. Feel the top of the head. I want you to, we say touching heaven, so you want to feel as the top of your head, crown of your head, Bai Wei Chinese, it's the top of the head, up, touches heaven. We're still getting our body into position. Correct alignment. Now I want to bring you to bring your awareness back to your breathing, in and out through the nose if you're able. Tip of the tongue resting on the hard palate on the roof of the mouth behind the top front teeth. How does the breath feel now? Is it natural? Does it feel forced? Is it more relaxed? Again, everybody breathes at a different rate. So whatever is normal and natural for you may not be normal and natural for the person next to you. What I want you to do now is visualize your heart. Some of you might be able to feel it beating in your chest. It's okay if you do not. Just understand that your heart beats continuously. Day and night, from the day you were born until the day you cross over, that heart beats. Now what I want you to do is to smile. Feel the joy in your heart. Tell your heart thank you. Doing its job. We feel it in our heart when we have joy, when we have happiness. Thank you, Mom. Tell yourself, tell your heart, thank, I am thankful, I am happy, thank you for beating, thank you for keeping me alive. Whatever words you use, you just want to feel happy about your heart. Think of it, smile at your heart, allow it to glow, feel the warmth of your love. child appreciates it. The more you connect with your heart, you may become aware of its beating. Become aware of your heart rate slowing down. That's a good thing. You want it to relax. The more relaxed the heart, the slower it beats, the stronger it is. Going to become aware of the lungs now. Back to the breath. Back to the lungs. Think about the lungs themselves. We certainly know a lot of information about the lungs these days. What's going on around us? This is especially important. The lungs are, if you smoke, or you have smoked in the past, or you have some sort of ailment that affects the lung or the breath, we want to take good care of our lungs. Take the oxygen in, convert it to carbon dioxide, and send it out. Feed the blood. Oxygenate the blood. Very important. So what I want you to do is smile at your lungs. Tell them thank you. You're doing a great job. Visualize them. Again, working tirelessly, non-stop. Keep us going. When we're awake, when we're asleep. When we exercise, or when we push ourselves, and we need to get more oxygen into the body. We need the lungs to function. Be able to bring that breath in, convert the oxygen, and send it on its way. Filter, think of them as large filters filtering the air around us. Send joy, send love to your lungs. Next, I want you to become aware of your kidneys. We have two kidneys, one on either side. Visualize those kidneys. They filter, like the liver, they're a filter. Kidneys are the home to our original chi. This is the chi, Q-I, C-H-I. This is the energy that we draw from our parents. It's called our original chi. Our foundation. build a house, think of the kidneys as the corner, the corners, the foundation, the base, that first brick that you lay as you build the structure around it. If that first brick is strong, it's a good foundation, and the building will stand for many years. If the building, if that brick is weak, broken, the building will lean, collapse, fall. There are lots of exercises, especially a lot of Qigong routines, and techniques to flush the kidneys. Say thank you to the kidneys. Thank you for keeping me going, keeping me alive. Smile at your kidneys. To move away from the organs, and I want you to think about a joint. Maybe you have knee issue or an ankle issue, maybe a hip, shoulder joints, elbows, wrists, fingers. Think about the joints. If you're a runner, think about the bones and the joints in your feet, the ankles. What happens to your knees when you run? What happens to your hips? If you play sports, tennis, baseball, cricket, what's happening at your shoulders, your elbows, your wrists? If you're a keen golfer, it's the spine, all that twisting, it's a lot of pressure in the spine. I want you to come up with one of your own joints now. Just one at a time. It's not fair that you spread yourself throughout the body. Don't just say, oh, these are all my joints. Think about one particular joint that you may be having trouble with. I want you to focus on that one joint. I want you to feel, visualize that joint. Send loving thoughts, caring feelings to that joint. Send your energy, your chi, to that joint. Some of you might feel heat around that joint. Some of you might feel coldness around that joint. If you don't, that's not important. Just in your mind, just focus on that one joint. tell that joint, it's okay. We'll get through this. Say, I am here. You've looked after me, I'm going to look after you. Again, you might feel heat, you might feel cold, you might feel nothing. It's okay, just keep focusing on the joint. Smile at the joint. Send warmth, send love to the joint. Ask you to bring your awareness back to your breath. Not the lungs, now the breath. How is your breathing? Does it feel relaxed? Is it calm? Tip of the tongue is resting on the hard palate on the roof of the mouth. Still. I'm going to ask you to take one deep breath in and exhale. Take another deep breath in. Exhale. Once more, deep, long breath in. And exhale. Become aware that you have a body. Joints, you have bones, you have muscles, you have a nervous system. Become aware of the space around you. And very gently open your eyes if they were closed or if they were gazing down. Just gaze straight ahead. Aware of your body. How is it sitting? Is it comfortable? If you need to, bring your hands together. Just rub your palms. You can massage the joints. I'm just massaging my kidneys. Down to the knees, hips, legs, sometimes sitting in a yoga meditation position for any length of time, you get some sort of pins and needles in the joints. So I think we were almost half an hour. So some of you who don't meditate, it's meditation can be easy. You can meditate for 5 minutes, you can meditate for an hour, you can meditate for hours at a time. Your body is in the right position, breath is aware of your breath. So again, I just want to thank you. It's the first day of May. I'm hoping that that we will actually see you in class at some point in the near future. We do open our doors. We're working hard to clean the facility. We have people coming in. We're listening to the rules. YMCA, not just Patchogue, may look a little different when you come back, but it's still your YMCA. We're here for you. Please don't hesitate to call us with your questions. Email me. My phone number here at the Y is 631-891-1813. So you can always call me if you have any questions or concerns about anything. And I wish you a very safe and happy weekend. Maybe you can get outside, maybe go for a walk, get some fresh air. Walk by the trees. It's the spring. Moving into yang, season, life. You see the trees around us blooming, trees are growing, we're emitting all this good yang qi. So you want to go out there and absorb it, get out there. All right, so have a nice weekend and stay safe.